October, maybe just a little bit too soon, and we would ask Cabinet if it could possibly change to November. So I don't know if anybody has any comments.
Okay, I was just going to, thanks for that, Bernie. I was just going to add to that that clearly this is a really important contract for the authority, and some of the key information is in confidential appendix, which we'll discuss later on. But can I just support Bernie in what she's just moved, and ask Kevin, who will be doing the negotiation. I think we need to have strong and robust discussions with with the contractor, and to make sure we do get absolutely the best value for money we can from any potential extension of this contract. So I could just emphasise the importance of that.
Yes, Chair, absolutely. Just to convey, Chair, any results of that negotiation will come back to Cabinet to agree what I'm seeking from you today. And certainly, so far, to the exact right. What I'm seeking today is permission to actually enter into those negotiations. I will do so very mostly. What I would not obviously is very sure that we will get any more back to Cabinet about it.
That's fine, okay. I'm happy with that. So can I suggest that we agree the recommendations as moved by Bernie? Are they agreed?
Really?
Okay, thanks very much. Right, okay, so that takes us then to agenda item 5, which is the notice of motion, ground bin tax and the digital divide. I'm delighted to welcome Councillor Kelly to Cabinet tonight. He tells me he's got a 3-page speech he's going to deliver to us. So, Stuart, do you want to come forward?
I might just have to project. I don't want to keep you too much. I think the issues are fairly clear. I think first of all, for responding in my emails. And also, actually, for accepting the fact that I'm raising the issue on the dollar wage charges doesn't automatically mean equal, if you like, but I'm convinced as the merit of it. So it's a very narrow area that I'm going to concentrate on. Just a bit of background as to why I drafted the resolution like I did. In April 2012, the council, you'll recall, passed the notice of motion, which was time proposed by Brian Kelly, which was entitled Digital Inclusion, amongst various other things. It noted that a high proportion of rural residents are digitally excluded and do not have access to the internet. It also noted, Chair, that the digital exclusion correlated closely to social and financial exclusion and opportunities to save money by accessing goods and services online. At that time, the council asked the acting chief executive to report to Cabinet on developing a digital inclusion plan to build. A couple of years later, October 2014, the council passed another resolution entitled Financial Exclusion, which limited, amongst other things, that many rural people cannot easily access mainstream financial services, and that the lack of access results in financial exclusion for people, and can mean that the cost of many financial transactions are higher, which results in stress for health and consumers. And at that time, the council resolved to ask the cabinet and chief executive to put in place a strategy to promote financial inclusion. Both of those motions were uncontroversial at the time. They were passed unanimously. So having a look at that, and turning my mind to the garden waste charge, which is the only service the council offers that differentiates between people who subscribe to it online and people who subscribe to it in other ways. It's the only one that does that. I've got to ask myself whether that differential charge meets the spirit of the notice of motion that was debated and passed at council. In order to best understand the impact, I did ask the department four figures from each ward of the numbers who subscribed and their method of subscribing. Shared that information with Cabinet members of the council have cited that information. just looking at this, because I ranked it in the order, if you like, of the highest proportion of people per ward that subscribed in, if you like, another method apart from online. Top of the list, right now, Tanya. Whilst the numbers went up large, the proportion of people from within Bedford and Tanya who were subscribing by another method, another time to pay extra, come from Bedford and Tanya, 25.6%, followed by Seacombe, followed by Winston St James, followed by Lisgar at 18%. The average share is 13.5% across the whole board. It's clearly when you get from more affluent areas, Clatterbridge, more people subscribing online, Hoylake Mills, 11% more people subscribing online, etc. Railroad Oxford Falls, Bangor, Liverpool, the creation of the But clearly you can see from that information that the wards that map to information we already have about where the low supermarket information tells us that there's a lot of deprivation of problems with accessing finance. More people in those areas are having to pay £5 more. And I would just simply submit to the council, to the council, that is unfair. It contributes to the financial exclusion, but most of the promotion that have been done in the past have attempted to adjust. The most solution that I moved was looking, perhaps optimistically, for that to be refunded. Came to 6 months into the year, I don't know if it was on now, that's just I think I would ask, reasonably ask, because I like to think that a politician goes for what's possible. The when can make its decisions next year on the charge? Increasing the charge isn't in the budget options, so I'm assuming that at the moment officers are looking at the £30, £35 being definitely the same. My view is that it should be standardised. Probably standardised at the £30 level, so that those people that choose not to subscribe online for various reasons, obviously that is interest, or whether it's to do with just general concern or put financial details into the computer. That's another one. The cover considered option. On the figures that I had at the time, that will come to a grand total of £23,000, which is a great deal. The bulk of the sense shown in fairness, people have felt that to be a constituency amount of property is there. With the stretch road surface, you can see that it's impacting more heavily in areas that we've already identified as suffering from various forms of digital and financial exclusion. I think that's all I'd like to say on that. I think we'll consider the resolution in favour of the lines of.
Okay, thanks for that, Stuart. Okay, I'm going to ask Bernie Mooney to respond to this.
Thanks, Stuart, for that. But I do think the start point of this is obviously to realise that the reason we're having to make such difficult decisions is because of the course that we're making, because of what's been happening at a national level and what it's related to our council. So I think that has to be acknowledged in the first place. That puts in a position to have to look for ways of finding every single penny that this council has, and that cannot be ignored. In May, in when we put the garden waste, the brown bin thing into being in May of 2013, it's estimated about 30,000 subscribers would sign up by the end of March. 30% we thought then would sign up online, potentially 9,000, which would mean the rest of the subscribers would be calling into the one-stop shops and calling the street scene. To meet the anticipated demand, we got extra staff at that time as part of the budget option into deal with the increase. To encourage the subscriptions to be used online, the £5 subscription discount was put into place. This was to encourage people to sign up online so that we didn't have to pay for as many staff one-stop shops, but also by signing up online, we had to be careful that we had the staff to do that. We had to make sure that we had the ability to deal with the calls and the pure volume of the service users contracted between May and June each year. It'd be too significant on the street scene business if everybody was calling the street scene and calling into the one-stop shop. So by signing up online, that would reduce all the staffing problems that we would have from that. So to encourage people to sign up online is very, very important. And the £5 discount was put there to encourage that. To assist the people in Wirral, we offered a free half-hour session in all our local libraries to help them access the internet. And they can also come in and get assistance to get email addresses for their families if they can come in, so their families can sign up for them. That is an option in all of their libraries. And when we haven't got staff in the libraries, there's volunteers that are available in the libraries to support people when they come in. When the subscription service was marketed for this year, renewal information was included and the support available was included by the, available by the council, but also there's the digital inclusion programme that's run by Age UK, which is why I sort of stated at the beginning that there's an interest in this. Age UK, funded by the council, we have a digital inclusion programme where if people need IT assistance in their home, people will go to their home and they will lend them IT equipment, laptops, and they'll actually go in and assist people to use them. So that facility is there also. If the £5 discount is removed, there is a real concern that residents will stop using the online service, and that will result in a significant increase in demand on the street scene, and this will have obviously a knock-on effect in the service that we provide to everybody with all the street scene business. And to address the matter, some residents not being able to subscribe online, we're currently exploring a number of things, such as direct debits and the use of automated phone lines and the use of pay points at the local post office. All of these considerations, though, will need IT changes, and there's a significant cost related to that, but we're trying to evaluate that at the moment. The council does not have the facility to offer online direct debit schemes at the moment because of the IT problems and because the current CRM system for recording subscriptions are not married up. We are working on that to see if that can be made more effective and be proved to be more cost-effective. If the council, is this the council's intention to continuously improve the value for money for garden-based subscriptions? So we need to encourage as many customers as possible to sign up online, for example, in order to improve service reliability, and currently exploring the viability of having an opt-out text message service to remind customers of collection day, for example. We're also considering putting a leaflet in with this year's council tax letters with all the information that Wirral's constituents will need for access and help at home. For instance, we will let them know that Age UK is available and that there's other people who are available to go in and help them in their homes. So we're hoping that that will help, but I really, really, really do have to emphasise when we put this in action in 2013, we had a forecasted saving of £1.1 million, and over the last 3 years we're hoping to be able to achieve £1.365 million because we've up to 40,000 people subscribing now, and we're doing everything we possibly can to help the people who are digitally excluded, and not only to be digitally excluded for the garden and green bins, but for anything else that they may feel excluded from. And you've got to remember that under the universal credits, people are going to be signing up online for more than just green bins. It's going to be the way of doing everything in the future. So we're going to do everything we possibly can to help people to be included more. Okay. I hope that